Dixie, and thank you for your time on the SABC News Desk.
Good afternoon, Keshni, and thank you for having me here.
MEC, a plunge in the matric pass rate in KwaZulu-Natal. What went wrong? You tell us.
Thank you very much for affording me this opportunity in order for me to explain to the nation what might have gone wrong, as we have experienced a situation whereby we declined from 69.7%, which we obtained during the previous academic year, to 60.7% this time around. Of course, we are very disappointed because we did not expect that. Actually, at the beginning of the year, after the release of 2014 matric results, we convened a provincial summit whereby we invited all our stakeholders to one venue, and then we identified all the gaps. We responded positively as the department to all what was raised in that particular summit. Like, for instance, there was an outcry out there that there were vacancies that needed to be filled. We filled all those vacancies for subject advisors, for circuit managers, and for other office-based officials. And of course, there was an outcry around the issue of the tools of trade that we needed to adequately provide for the tools of trade. We did exactly that. We developed a strategy which was referred to as Operation Bounce Back, whereby the intention was to ensure that we improve on our performance as the Department of Education in KZN. It was embraced and adopted by all stakeholders. We went out there, we monitored the implementation thereof, and we were satisfied towards the beginning of the examinations that we have done everything. But of course, I must also indicate that you will recall that during the 2014 examinations, there was that challenge around irregularities that happened in some of our schools, especially those that are in rural areas. This time around, we developed a strategy. Our systems became very tight. Ensuring that there would be not even a single school that will participate in irregular activities like your group copying and other irregular activities. We trained our monitors. We physically visited all centers, examination centers. Everybody participated, including the Portfolio Committee on Education. Everybody really, really participated. We thought we had done our best, only to find that we are experiencing this 9% decline now. We are still going to analyze our performance, and ensure that we analyze the performance of each and every school and the performance of each and every subject, because there are those subjects which have really improved, and there are those subjects that have not improved in terms of pass percentages.
Yes, MEC, definitely strategy is in place, but we're not seeing it coming through now in the results we're seeing this year. When was the last time that your department created posts for teachers? Some teacher unions are saying that you haven't done much to address challenges like overcrowding of classrooms and educator overload, critical shortages of teachers, etc. Some classes still have as many as 80 learners. How do you respond?
Of course, because of scarcity of resources in particular, it becomes difficult to create posts in the department. But that doesn't mean that there are no educators in schools. We are continuously employing educators, and the system, the education system as a whole, is continuously training educators, because you must recall that in KZN in particular, there has been a challenge whereby it has been very difficult to recruit qualified educators, especially in rural areas. The National Minister, Mme Angie Motshekga, has developed a program whereby you take grade 12 learners to universities. They become trained as educators, especially qualifying in teaching maths and science. We are doing that. We are encouraging a number of them to be enrolled in tertiary institutions, especially here in KZN, through UKZN and other universities that are located in our province. So we are doing our best. Of course, we can never be complacent. What needs to be done right now is go back to the drawing board and identify again those challenges and develop strategies and programs that will assist us to avert whatever adversity that we might experience going forward. Mm.
This is the second consecutive year, MEC, that KZN has not fared well in the matric results. In 2014, the pass rate having dropped by 7.7% compared to 2013. What will you do differently this year?
Indeed, I fully agree with you that it's a second year whereby we, especially during this period, whereby we are focusing on CAPS. Of course, we'll have to re-strategize as a department and look at the gaps that might have occurred. I am not the only one who is shocked about this performance. Even the officials in the department did not expect this, because really we had thought that this time around we were going to improve. I did not even have stress during the festive season, because I was expecting positive results, only to find that we have not performed to that level. We have declined. We are going to go back to the drawing board together with our stakeholders and ensure that we identify gaps and then try to improve on our performance.
Thank you, MEC, for your time on the News Today desk. That was MEC for Education in KwaZulu-Natal, Peggy Nkonyene.